Hi everybody, it's Jerry here, welcome back. Tonight I am going to be doing some pier fly rodding. Somewhat traditional style, definitely not traditional, but we're just using standard equipment. And looking for striper or bluefish, not sure what's going to happen tonight, but there have been fish around. A little bit of what I'm doing tonight, maybe a little bit more than a little bit, what I'm doing. Hopefully we get a few fish. And there'll be more fish than talking. If not, there'll be more talking than fish. This is how it goes. Okay, I'm going to get started and just going to explain what I'm doing. I also have a pretty good video about how I approach pier rodding with some more information if you're interested. The link is in the corner, I think. You can click on that when you're done with this video. And it's a very effective, fun way to fish. But alright, let's get started. And you can see I do carry, I think, the top color. Just use your favorite. These are just effective colors that I have found work. One of my favorite actually is a blonde, Koblo, gold, Klaus, or Thai. Pretty much they're the same. And when I pick a fly to use, I pick a pattern I can tie fast. So I can tie off a whole set of these in about 15 minutes, get out fishing. Save time. To me, that's more effective than multi-feathered, crazy-looking flies. I like something simple, I can tie quick, effective, and that works. That's why I enjoy tying and throwing these. Tie them off quick, you know, after lunch or breakfast. Well, I don't eat lunch. But you get the point. And just line up your stuff, get them out, get out fishing. And that's why I like trying these here, deep Klaus and minnows. I like the olives, yellows, chartreuse, and of course this is one of my favorite. It's a blonde gold. Imitate anything from bait fish to shrimp. Stuff. show you one of the standard casts I use. It's just a regular road cast. It gets me out about a good 40 feet. But I just will roll and shoot the light. And it's you don't need much energy. Probably less than you would use with standard spinning or conventional tack. And you just repeat. Of course, if there's no one around, just be aware of your surroundings. You can do a plain old overhand cast. I do not like doing a lot of false casts. There's no need for that. Just overhand cast. I leave a little bit more line out than I had. One of the things, if you're casting, just learn how to lift your line up off the water. You'll avoid a whole bunch of false casts. You can see my line is out of the water. Lift it up and shoot it out. And I'm out over 60 feet there. With a false cast, I'll be through that spool line. I can get out 80 feet without, whipping it back and forth unnecessarily. Get out there, you're going to be doing more fish and less cast, and that's what you want to do. That's how you're going to catch more fish, is keep your lure in the water. Let me show you again. Just a simple lift. A lot of the retrieves, I do not use any kind of steady retrieve. One of my favorites is they call this a figure eight, although I don't figure eight the line. I just kind of, I'll drop it, but just kind of crawl that fly through. That's one of my favorite retrieves. Another is just, I'll let that fly sink. I almost move my rod across. I think just give it a little rod tip twitch and feed it line. There's something to a twitch and a drop. I hit a lot of fish like that. And of course you have your standard strip. Get that fly where you want it, and then you can feed it back. I like to give it a little turn, but it's a little... I'm not a big fan of the steady retrieve. And of course, one of my favorites is I go way upstream. I let my line sink with my fly. You can even walk a little over. It's going to drop, and I hit a lot of fish just twitching that rod tip as it turns. Very effective retrieve. But I do not use one steady retrieve. If I go out there and I know there's fish, I'm not getting something, I'm going to switch it up. That's just the bottom line. You might go faster, slower, deeper, higher. I mean, very rarely higher. You always try to go deeper. But you're not going to get too deep. You're going to get deep enough to move in the water. Those are some of the retrieves. There are times where I just hold the fly in a zone, twitch and drop, twitch and drop, twitch and drop. And that's it. That works too. If there's bluefish around, sometimes a really fast retrieve drop. I mean fast. They key in on that sometimes. So you have to play with them. And they're just like any other fish. Even a striper too sometimes. You give it a really fast accelerated retrieve. It's almost like a dead stop. Let it sink. And a lot of times they key in on that. But change it up, see what works, and just fish. Here's one of the retrieves I like. Let the fly sink and go with your line. And I'll twitch, drop, twitch, pull, twitch, 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 twitch. Just like that. It's you never know what they're gonna go after. Change it up in between and whatnot, but this is a pick up a few fish like that. Actually let it drop a little. Something about the drop. That's a fish like. Thank you. same wheel, same manufacturing process from England. They work great. Got a rim control. As for the rod, it's just a standard 8 weight, 8 foot, I believe. Fly rod, carbon graphite, gets the job done. As for the line I've been using tonight, it's a sinking line. So what I would say, medium sink rate, I think. It's got to be about 4 inches per second. As for my leader, I use, this is about 3 feet now. Berkeley, 30 pound big game. I actually would prefer to use 12 or 15, but I have to pull those fish up, so I use 30 straight here. But if I was in the water, I'd probably go more so a 12 pound or even heavy. One quick thing I would like to say about fishing. I talked to a few people, or people talk to me, and they tell me, you know, what's going on, this and that, this is how you do things. That's not how I think. Things change, they vary, there's a lot going on, and when you're fishing, you just don't know, you know. There's no absolutes when you're fishing. It changes day by day, week by week, sometimes month by month, and year by year. You can't expect the same results every time you go. Things change. So one thing I like to just say is, if you don't go by the book, you know, don't be afraid to throw the book aside and do what you do. And I like to say, follow your gut. I do a lot of that. And a big part of it, you just keep that in mind. Now, of course, you got like general patterns, but those general patterns are exactly that, general. Go against, you know, what you feel is happening. Big, you know, big thing. And just gotta kind of jump in the cold water and see what happens. Let's get the fish. Thank you. Okay, everybody. Of course, I'm going to take a deep breath, but I am going to go into one thing I like to make note of. Fishing is pretty neat because every time you go out, you see and experience different things. It always changes. You never know it all. You can't know it all. And that's what I really like about this sport. But thanks again for watching. Please like, dislike, comment. Love them all, good, bad, whatever you have to say. Subscribe to the channel. And remember, please fish your way. Thanks again for watching. And have a great night or day, whatever it is. One thing I want to note, and I think I have mentioned this before, is especially with striped bass or any fish, bluefish, reedfish, loop, they're not on the feed, they're around. They're not on the feed. You're not going to catch them, even if you're looking at them. I mean, you almost have to wait for them. Something goes off, and then they go on the feed. A lot of times they chase and take and being difficult. Sometimes they're on the feed and they will take. Other times they're just not on the feed, they're just there. And you are not going to catch them no matter what you do. You know what you throw at them? You hit them in the head. I've done that. And they're just not going to take. It's just something to think about. But if you know that they're there, they will go on the feed eventually. Certain times, triggers and whatnot that turn those fish on. Just keep that in mind when you're fishing. Don't get discouraged fishing through, because they will go on to bite any fish.